What's up, you guys? It's Graham here. So normally on the channel, we talk about the best places to grow your money where you could get the ideal customer experience and do all of that for absolutely free. But today is not that video. Instead, I've scoured through dozens of banks, read hours of fine print, and subjected myself to the worst terms imaginable just so that I could come up with what I believe to be the five worst banks currently in existence that you should avoid at all costs. Because the fact is, most people have no idea what they sign up for, and they think a lot of these egregious terms are normal until they look at their statement, see the monthly fees racking up higher than the Empire State Building, and not knowing that all of that was easily preventable had they just seen this video first and smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm. And also, I want to say a big thank you to Citibank for sponsoring this video. Just kidding, guys. There is no sponsor. Let's begin over at my desk now. Now, I want to make it clear, as a self-proclaimed personal finance enthusiast on YouTube, it's my job to know firsthand what's going on in the world of banking. And for that reason, I have personally banked with every single company listed here in this video to give you a first-hand experience of exactly what it's like, including our number five, and that would be Bank of America. And I gotta say, if I'm being completely objective, they do have a few really good qualities about them, which is why I'm mentioning them first in the list. One, they got a really good credit card for anyone just starting out, and that would be the Bank of America Cash Rewards credit card. There's no annual fee, the rewards are decent, including 0% interest for the first 15 months, and they give you a $200 bonus when you sign up and spend $1,000 in the first 3 months. Second, they also have decent mortgage options for anyone looking to get a loan. In fact, in 2018, I refinanced my property through them because at the time they had the lowest interest rate. And finally, number three, before I absolutely go off on them, their online interface is incredibly easy to use, and it's really easy to track transactions on there and customize them and name them whatever you want. But that is where I draw the line, because everything else after that is a bit of a train wreck. Even though they love to entice you with pictures of happy couples and millennials just hanging out, biting their nails, that's all just a cover-up for the more sinister aspects of their banking system, and that would be a $12 monthly maintenance fee. Of course, this is waived if you're an eligible student under the age of 24, enable direct deposit, maintain the minimum daily balance of $1,500, or you enroll in the preferred rewards, which is something I will mention momentarily. But let's talk about fees, where you will find, by the way, a $35 overdraft fee, a $30 wire fee, a $15 incoming wire fee, a $15 cashier's check fee, a $5 lost card replacement fee with a $15 rush delivery, and even though they have a whole bunch of random fees on top of random fees, at least that's partially waived if you're a preferred rewards customer, so that makes it slightly better until you get into the interest. If you have a normal checking account like the one you use day to day, you're not going to earn any interest whatsoever. If you want to earn interest, you have to sign up for the Bank of America interest checking account, which pays you a whopping 0.01% interest. Unless, of course, you have more than $100,000 with them, in which case they pay you 0.02% interest. Since most people don't have that amount of money just sitting in a checking account, let's talk about the savings account, which also pays you 0.01% interest. But if you want to earn more interest, you know what? Not a problem. All you got to do is maintain an average daily balance of $20,000 to get bumped up to their gold preferred rewards, which then boosts your interest rate all the way up to 0.02%. From there, if you have $50,000 or more, congratulations, you will be bumped up to their platinum tier, which gets you 0.03% interest. Needless to say, Bank of America is good if you're a student, you like their credit card, you want a really easy to navigate website, and you don't mind pulling out your hair every night looking at the fees. But in terms of their actual bank account, for me it's a disaster, but it only gets worse. After that, we got another one that I really wish were not on this list, and that would be HSBC. Now here's the thing, they used to be a really good bank. In fact, they were named one of the best savings accounts in 2020 when they paid 2.05% interest. Shortly after, news came out that they allegedly turned a blind eye to money laundering, and more recently, they were questioned about their knowledge and involvement behind these practices. On top of that, they recently announced that they would be closing down their banking offices across the US to focus instead on high net worth client management. As a result, all accounts with less than $75,000 will be impacted, as well as businesses who operate with less than $5 million in annual revenue. Because of that, I've moved the majority of my money out of HSBC, but I still have enough with them to be impacted by the change. And as of now, it looks like that portion of the business is going to be sold to Citizens or Cathay Bank while the remaining accounts are moved over. In this case, Cathay Bank is the only option that operates in Nevada, and for them, they charge you a $6 monthly maintenance fee with no balance minimum to avoid being charged. The only way around this service fee is to upgrade to a personal checking account with a $10 monthly maintenance fee unless you keep a daily average balance of $1,000. And if you want to earn any interest whatsoever, you're going to have to upgrade again to the Value Plus checking account with a $2,000 daily minimum balance. Otherwise, you're going to get charged charged with a monthly $15 fee. But hey, at least on the plus side, you're going to get 24/7 online account access, including bill pay and Cathay People Payment at no charge. Which is pretty much code word for saying that they're not going to charge you to log in online, but you know what, I digress. Their interest rate is slightly better than Bank of America, 0.02% interest for all balances above $2,000, and if you want to earn 0.05% interest, you'll only need $20,000 minimum. That was sarcasm. Now, the savings accounts really aren't any better either. The normal account is $3 a month unless you carry the minimum $500 balance. And if you want to earn more interest, just open up their Smart Money Market Fund with a minimum of $5,000 and you can earn 0.05%. But don't you worry, it gets worse. They also have the Optima Money Market Fund that charges you $50 a month if your balance drops below $100,000. And with that, you get the privilege of earning 0.1% interest. And just wait, if you have more than $1 million with them, you'll get to earn 0.25% interest. Yeah, I know, it's bad. So HSBC basically pulled the rug on its customers, shut down all accounts under $75,000, and then sold themselves to a bank that charges even higher fees. Although if you thought things couldn't possibly get any worse, they do. Welcome to banking with Wells Fargo. Now, this one shouldn't be much of a surprise given their checkered past with controversy. I mean, you know it's bad when there's a website that's literally dedicated to a list of all of their past scandals, including making fake accounts, improperly repossessing cars, failing a test that they could unwind during a bankruptcy, creating even more fake accounts, awarding $5.4 million to a whistleblower for fraud, lawsuit for overcharging small businesses, penalizations from the Federal Reserve, altering business information without client knowledge, securities fraud, and that's just the tip of the iceberg. More recently, they're facing a lawsuit over their employees' 401k for steering them into investments that Wells Fargo gets a higher commission on, even when other lower-cost options were available. But scandals aside, in terms of how the actual bank is, it's not really that good. Let's begin with the checking account. I love, by the way, on the website that they advertised that you could open an account with $25. Seems easy, right? After all, it is the most popular option. Except when you see that they have a $10 monthly maintenance fee unless you keep a minimum of $500 in the account or have qualifying deposits of at least $500 every calendar month. But at least on the bright side, I gotta hand it to Wells Fargo for at least being upfront about this and putting this on their front page so I don't have to spend an hour searching for it. Although speaking of the fine print, when you go and open up the PDF, you'll see that with Wells Fargo, you will enjoy a $15 wire transfer fee for incoming money, a $30 wire transfer fee for outgoing wires, a $10 charge for cashier's checks, and yeah, a lot of other fees. All, by the way, without giving you any interest. Nice. However, let's just say that you're too fancy for that account and you want something, well, nicer. In that case, they've just announced a brand new Wells Fargo portfolio account with a monthly service fee of $25. Now, you know it's going to be bad when they don't mention the interest rate at the top of the page, and instead you have to scroll all the way down to the bottom to find it at 0.01%. Yeah, seriously, for an account with a maintenance fee of $25 a month, just to get 0.01%. Although the good news is that you could waive the $25 monthly maintenance fee if you keep a minimum balance of $20,000 in the account, and if you could do that, you'll get to enjoy all the amazing benefits, like not being charged a Wells Fargo ATM fee, not being charged for getting a wire transfer, $0 cashier's checks, and no fees for using their digital services, which basically just means they're not going to charge you for logging in on their website. Now, their savings account is not that much better either. The Platinum account carries a monthly maintenance fee of $12 unless you keep a minimum balance of $3,500 a month, and you also get an interest rate of 0.01%, which is the same thing as getting slapped in the face. Their interest rates are also so low that they've discontinued their relationship pricing for customers with more than $250,000, because it appears as though no matter how much money you have with Wells Fargo, the most interest they can offer you is 0.02%. But for $250,000, they do have a few perks, like unlimited free stop payments on checks, no foreign transaction fees on your debit card, and that's pretty much it. So as you could see from a bank as large as Wells Fargo, they're charging you for as many things as they possibly can while paying you the bare minimum they could get away with, coming from a bank with a history of scandal after controversy after scandal. That's why I made the choice to cancel my Wells Fargo account a few years ago, and since then, I have never looked back. But wait, there's more. We got the next one on the list, and that would be Citibank. Now, it's important for me to mention that there have only ever been two banks that I have gone out of my way to cancel, and Citibank was one of them. And it's really a shame because the Citi double cash Rewards credit card is a great card, but beyond that, as far as the bank itself, it's not looking good. Now, one of the main reasons I shut down my Citibank account is because their mobile deposit limit was so low, at the tune of $1,000 a day or $3,000 a month. Now, you're probably hearing that and you think to yourself,
but Graham, $1,000 a day is a lot of money. That's $365,000 a year.
Except when you have any single check above $1,000, even if it's $1,001, you can't use the mobile app to deposit it. And if you exceed $3,000 in a month, you're out of luck and either have to deposit a check in person at a branch or mail it in, which I'm not gonna do. But just wait, it doesn't stop there. When you go to their main website, it looks as though they're running all of these exciting new cash bonus promotions, like earn up to $1,500 or get rewarded for saving more, up to $2,000. Except their version of saving more is depositing $1,000,000 to get the $2,000 bonus, which is just atrocious. But let's just assume for a moment that you don't have $1,000,000 sitting in cash to deposit with Citibank. In that case, the rewards are still, well, lacking, and to go over that, we should start with the checking account. Their basic account starts at $10 a month unless you maintain a minimum balance of $1,500, but you don't get any paper checks. If you want that ability, well, that costs you $12 a month or the same $1,500 minimum balance. And if you dare want to earn any interest, well, that is going to cost you $25 a month or $10,000 in combined balances. And when that happens, you get to earn 0.01% interest. Now, the savings accounts are more of the same with the same fees and the same minimums as the checking account, except you get to earn all the way up to 0.13% interest on balances above $500,000. And if you're a real big spender and you keep a daily balance of at least $50,000, you could qualify for priority banking, where your checking account can earn a staggering 0.03% and a 0.15% interest rate on balances above $500,000. And just wait, it gets better. If you're a Citi Gold client, you could also get access to their wealth management team, who charges 1% or $65 for each trade you make through them. Or if you're into options trading, well, that'll be $2.95 plus 75 cents per contract. But that's actually pretty tame when you compare it to our next option, which for me is the worst bank on this entire list, and that would be US Bank. Now, what's surprising is that until just recently, their website looked like this, straight from 1999. And it wasn't until a few months ago that they redesigned their website to make it look a bit more modern. So now you can see just how bad their bank is in 2021 format. Now, initially, I didn't want to be a US Bank customer, but I was somewhat forced to when they became the lender for Tesla in 2019. And when I went to get an auto loan, they were the only option. So I gave it a shot thinking, how bad could it really be? Well, if you want a checking account, they start off at the low cost of $6.95 a month unless you keep an average balance of at least $1,500. Their gold checking account gets you even more upgrades though for $14.95 a month, like not paying an ATM fee at a US Bank ATM, the eligibility to save in your mortgage closing costs, and this one is wild, 100 free trades through their stock trading brokerage. I kid you not, in 2021, when pretty much every stock trading brokerage gives you free trades, including public that you could use down below in the description to get a free stock when you use the code Graham that's worth all the way up to $1,000. US Bank is still charging trading fees and using 100 free trades as a perk. Although to waive the $14.95 charge, you'll have to take out either a personal loan, line, or credit card where they can make even more money from you. Now, the Platinum checking account, however, is where it's at. They've got competitive rates and all the perks, including the ability to earn interest at 0.01% throughout all balances, access to the banking must-haves like a debit card and online banking, free paper statements, and discount on checks with personal designs. And don't worry, that $24.95 monthly fee is going to be waived if you keep at least $25,000 in your account. As for their savings account, it's not that much better, unfortunately. Their exclusive savings account for top-tier customers pays you 0.01% on all amounts, which kind of makes me think they don't really know the meaning of competitive. Because I gotta say, these are only competitive to literal garbage. And even though almost all of their savings accounts technically don't have a monthly maintenance fee, you need a checking account to be eligible for the savings account, which as we all know, has a monthly maintenance fee, so you're kinda just stuck. However, there was one final savings option which caught my attention, and that would be the Elite Money Market account, where you could earn more interest on high balances for the price of $10 a month or $10,000 minimum account balances. But don't get your hopes up, up because that must have been a typo, since earn more interest just takes you to the same landing page, which pays you 0.01% interest on all balances. At least just update the website to say that there's nothing special about this, and it all pays you the exact same, regardless of how much you're spending. Personally, I don't know how anyone could be enticed by rates like this, and I see it as a stain on the entire banking industry to offer 0.01% regardless of how much money you have. Now sure, some of these banks are definitely convenient, as in there's a Wells Fargo and Bank of America every few blocks for anyone who actually wants to go into a bank physically. But for purposes of being a financially responsible adult, there are way better options out there. For example, Ally Bank has no minimums, their checking account pays you 0.15%, and their savings account pays 0.5%, all without crazy fees or barriers to jump through. Marcus by Goldman Sachs also offers you another high interest savings option with 0.5% interest with no fees. And a place like Redneck Bank pays you 0.45% interest on a checking account with loads of other features for $0. And in the meantime, if you bank with one of these places I've mentioned here in the video, at least you understand what you're being charged, and you could better make the decision if you want to change or if you want to smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm. So with that said, you guys, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. As always, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Also, feel free to add me on Instagram. I post pretty much daily, so feel free to add me there, as on my second channel, The Graham Stephan Show, I post there every single day. I'm not posting here. So if you want to see a brand new video from me every single day, make sure to add yourself to that. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time.